Hello! In this tutorial, I'll teach you how to make an outfit, make some clothes for our Simon character here. I highly recommend doing it from a duplicate. Then let's select the lasso option or the lasso option, whatever. And I'm going to remove the upper torso, including the head and arms and feet. And I'm going to lock this section here and go to the deformation menu. This is one of my secret techniques that I use to make clothes. I apply some polish and I, you know, smooth the edges of the geometry a little bit. This will just make our lives easier. And then we can use some options like we can go to the geometry menu, go to the Dynamesh option, lower the resolution more or less to 16, and then activate the Dynamesh. Here, we can close the polygons, and the next thing we can do is go to the draw menu and enlarge the brush to apply a general smoothing. So this smoothing will allow us to get rid of all the irregularities present there in the geometry. Then we can use the inflate tool from the deformation menu. Just dial it up a little bit so that it overlaps the lower geometry while still staying true to the general profile of the legs. And everybody wants to stay true to the leg profile. Then with the standard brush and, you know, a much lower intensity, we can clean up some of the spots this way. Perfecto! You got to do each side here, so, you know, you're just smoothing it out so it covers all those areas. We don't want uncovered areas. Next, the most detailed parts, that's stuff like wrinkles, you know, I'm going to go down with a Z remesher and tweak all that really dense, high resolution geometry. I'm going to mess it up a little, make it less clean. Later, we add a pair of subdivisions at 2, and then I soften it a whole bunch. I'm adding all the details with the standard brush, and I just repeat this process again and again to get the look that I want. Once you're done, you'll want to do some retopology. We're gonna make some lower poly stuff. And of course, just remember to decimate your mesh in ZBrush, which you'll want to do so it's more manageable, you know, in any of these traditional 3D modeling programs. We can create a layer and place the template mesh right in there. Then I go to the taskbar and I activate the link with the magnet icon and then put the symmetry in X. Now I'm going to use the modeling tools here in Maya and activate the quad draw. If we're using active symmetry, we can do it on both sides at the same time. Now we just have to draw the polygons of the garment to get optimized meshes for animations. This is a really simple way to create and edit polygons. So, you know, it goes faster if you memorize the hotkeys. You got tab to extrude. You have control to close a polygon after drawing the points. In this way, we can generate a mesh with much lower resolution, and you can take it later to animate an iClone. So I really recommend doing this process, even if it takes a little bit longer. I promise it'll give really good results in the end when you put out a render or an animation. I know it can feel really arduous to feel like you're modeling a mesh twice, but learn to love it. Embrace the pain. Once you're done doing polygons for the sweater here, you can understand the process is the same for a coat and for the pants. So now using a front view, I'm going to make a quick UV from camera view, and then I activate the editor and go back to the perspective window. I put my mesh in object mode. And I'll delete history here to optimize resources. So I'm gonna add a checker material, and that's gonna allow me to see how the UV is behaving in real time in relation to the texture. Clicking lots of buttons clicking. And in the repeat UV option, I'll set that to 8x8. In this way, we're making sure I can see a better density of information in the UV editor. I deactivate these elements here, and now I can start working. So we have this 3D object on a 2D plane, and we want to edit it so it's nicely organized, and we're able to apply a high-quality material with lots of detail without any stretching or other issues. So I'll select some edges here, in places that would have seams on a real sweater. Remember to disable symmetry, actually, to work with UVs. I'll go to the Create panel, then Cut. And I've separated the sleeves. All right, so I do the same for the bottom hem. Rather than UV editing, let's just say I'm sewing and tailoring. I've got seams on the undersides of the sleeves and down the side of the torso and separating the cuffs. So now we're gonna make a nice texture in Substance Painter. I'll just use some basic materials, create a new project, and I'm selecting the file I just made, clicking through my hard drive to find it, and I'm gonna add all the maps that I baked previously. You can do that baking in ZBrush or in other types of software with more specialized tools. In any case, you just bake the high poly details to the low poly models. That process is pretty simple, and it depends on what software you're using. Substance is a really powerful one. I recommend it. I'm gonna rename each of the sections here. Working like this, it's super important to give each one a unique name so you can tell what you're doing. Now I drag each texture to its corresponding section, in this case, the normal map. Rather than put it on the shoes, I remember to select the sweater. As you can see, the high poly stuff from ZBrush applies really nicely. And of course, I'll do the same thing for all of the corresponding maps. You got ambient occlusion, curvature, the position map, and the thickness. Likewise, I repeat that process for each of the clothing pieces. And once I'm done, I can start adding some materials. Yes, materials, my favorite. This is the fun part. I recommend using the basic materials, especially when you're generating fabrics. I just think it works a lot better. In this case, I want to stick with very simple materials, stuff that stands out and has some nice texture and color in equal parts. More or less, I'm trying to stick to the patterns and colors on the reference character's clothes. But of course, it'll be something with a lot more graphical fidelity here than in the original concept. So I keep copying the colors with the dropper, and of course I'm paying close attention to the fabric pattern that generates a little texture here. That's a lot of small details. Nice. How about I work on some of the larger strokes here? So for example, those big fabric folds at the base of the sweater. Once you're done the texture, we can pass through our handy Go Z, just like we've done previously at the other stages for our character. In this case, I have a sweater with me this time, and I select the conform option. And then I calculate the collision. Something really cool that Go Z gives us, actually, is that by doing it this way, the skin weights are automatically applied to each part of the clothing individually, so you don't have to do it manually. And all the clothing parts just adjust to the movement of the joints, and that's very nice to have. I'm going to load the textures. I'm changing the shading to PBR, and I'm individually importing the maps I exported from Substance. Just like in previous videos, I adjust the diffuse color, make it full white, and of course the normal map. Adding normal maps is always my favorite part. Am I the only one? Here, click the Flip Y box to preview it correctly, since sometimes maps exported from Substance, sometimes it can just be like that, you know? And when it be like that, you gotta deal with that. Am I right? Repeat the procedure with the pants, remembering to activate all of our fancy options and importing the maps in their respective places. I do the same with the shoes. Perfect. I changed some shoe maps. All right, now we can do several things. The first is we can edit the skin weights. One of the problems that you can find is that when editing a pose, when I select a joint to move it, while I'm doing this, I can see that the clothes might be funky. Like this, the joint of the opposite leg has some weight painted in places it shouldn't. To fix it, super easy. I just find my skin weights option from settings. And once I load the window, notice it shows us our polygons. Using that, you can see the influence of each bone in real time. So, from selection mode, I grab this vertex here that's being influenced, and I select the thigh bone there, and I assign a value of 9. Now, it's partially fixed, but tweaking the weight a little bit more can get us the whole way there. And as you can see, this isn't so bad. I recommend clicking through all your bones here and just taking a peek at what they control via these weight paints so you can familiarize yourself with this aspect of 3D design. Now I'm gonna check the opposite side, move the leg around. In this case, everything looks pretty swanky. Now, another thing to fix when dealing with your clothes is, when moving a joint, I can see that the internal geometry overlaps with the external clothing. You can fix that like this. I'm gonna remove the hair for a second. I've got it saved somewhere else already. Now, I go to the Modify menu and activate the Cloth Layer settings. I'm gonna assign a different layer to each section of clothing. 9 for the sweater. 1 for the shoes, and finally 6 for the pants. Press OK, and then activate the Auto Hide Mesh option. This allows us to change the internal geometry, what was giving us trouble, and we can check out how it looks. I go to the Scene tab, I activate wireframe mode, and check that the skin part of the legs is gone. And now to wrap this up, I'll just bring back my hair, dragging it from the library, And finally, I add an accessory beard to make him look even cooler. And now I'll just edit the pose a little bit. Make sure everything is moving properly. Perfecto. What we can do next is save each of the pieces. I'll go to the pose panel and I'll try some different poses, something to illustrate the movement of the clothes. Could be surfing.
Oh, surf's up, dude. Let's hang 10.
Or you could do something relaxed and chill. Hey, what's up? Once you're happy and you've got a good pose, go to the clothing panel, then the custom tab, and I'm going to start saving all of my clothes into my library. I select and press the plus button there, and I name it. Names are important. Now I go to the scene and I hide everything else to make a thumbnail capture that shows the specific clothing off better. And I repeat the process with the pants. Look at those pants! They look awesome! And then with the shoes. Bingo bango bongo! Now I can import a different avatar. For example, this here dude. And I can add the clothing we just saved to him. I'm just gonna give him a default pose. I'll remove his top and import my sweater. And it automatically adjusts. I remove the bottom shorts here and find my new pants in the library. And finally, I'm just gonna drag in the shoes. So here's a new guy, fully dressed, nice and fast. I can even do some new poses with this guy. And the same outfit works perfectly. See you next time.